Hi everyone, Mr. H here. So good to see you again. So today for our final class of the year, we are going to be answering the question, what movie would go with this music? So we're going to listen to some music that came from actually three different movies, and we're going to see what other movies could this music go to. Now we already know how important music is to a movie. It helps tell the story, it helps flavor the scene, it helps tell the audience what's going on without ever using any words. So we're going to do this here. We're going to listen to a little bit of a piece of music from one movie and try to think, what other movies could this go to? Now, like I said, we're going to kind of cheat a little since you can see where this one came from. This is going to be from the first Pirates of the Caribbean movie. But the question is, what other movies could it go with? It'll help close your eyes while you're listening so you can think, all right, what's happening in the music? What are we listening to? What other scenes could this go with? So let's listen. He's a Pirate from Pirates of the Caribbean. So what kind of movie or what kind of scene could go with that one? I mean, it's pretty exciting music. It's got a lot of things going on. It's, you know, a very driving beat. It's kind of loud. I think this one would definitely work a lot more with an action movie or an adventure movie. Maybe not as funny or as dramatic, but definitely would go with something like that. Maybe you have a different idea, but that's kind of what I felt. Obviously, we know it came from an action movie. Pirates of the Caribbean is very much an action movie. But as a composer, you have to think about what could go with what. I'm sure if you listen to this music, you probably think it sounds like a bunch of other music as well. Well, like we said, Hans Zimmer worked on this music and he wrote a lot of other movies. So sometimes some bits of music ends up in more than one movie. Now, let's switch things up a bit. I'm gonna play it again. We're gonna go to this one. Now this is from the movie Tron Legacy. I don't know if you've seen it, but I enjoyed it a little bit and I enjoyed the music a lot. It's done by the band Daft Punk. It's pretty cool. So we're gonna listen to this scene and same thing. We know that this music came from a more action adventure type movie, but where else could it be put in? All right. So there was that music from that movie. Now, did you notice this wasn't necessarily a normal like orchestra? This was actually electronic music. Daft Punk performs, yes, with orchestral instruments, but also with music you make out of a computer. So a composer can really make music out of anything. A lot of times, yeah, they're going to be using symphony orchestras with like violins and trumpets and clarinets and all that. But other times, they're using music that comes from computers, or maybe both, and they mix them together. So this was a different kind of a feel. Now, if you've seen Tron, you know why they used a lot of electronic music. It all takes place in a computer. So it kind of makes sense that you use computerized music to make music about a computer movie. But where else would this kind of music work? What would be happening in that scene or in that movie? For me, it's a lot less intense. It's more like they're discovering something, like maybe someone's entering a big city for the first time and you're getting a feel of just what happens in the city, you know, the hustle and bustle and things like that. But maybe this is a futuristic city, which is why they use the computer music. So it's kind of an idea of you're doing something different. So how can you make that work? Now, we're going to change it up one more time. We're going to go to a piece of music from Guardians of the Galaxy. Now, Guardians of the Galaxy is a version of a movie that had two different kinds of soundtracks, which is the, you know, the music you hear from the movie. The first one usually comes from the film composer, and that's the instrumental soundtrack, you know, a lot of the background music and things like that. But sometimes they have one where the soundtrack is music from the movie, like actual singing song movies. So things like, you know, the Disney movies like Moana or Frozen or Big Hero 6 or anything like that, where they actually have people singing in the movie, that's part of the soundtrack. But also sometimes they just get popular music from the time and they put it together in an album. So this is what they did here. This is a song called Ain't No Mountain High Enough, and it came out actually way back in the 60s, I believe. But they used it in the movie. And this is something composers have to think about too. When they're using pop music like that, what scene would you use that in? So we're going to listen to a little of this, not all of it. What kind of a scene would you use this music in?
Listen, baby. Ain't no mountain high, ain't no valley low, ain't no river wide.
So, a totally different kind of music. It's not orchestral, it's not electronic, it's popular music, it's pop music. So, what kind of a scene would use this kind of music? Maybe like a montage where a lot of things happen really quickly to show the passage of time. Maybe it's just a fun party scene and everybody's just having fun enjoying their time. Maybe it's at the end of the movie and they're celebrating the end of the adventure, the end of whatever happened and it had a happy ending to it. I don't know. But those are some options. I know that's what I would do with this. So what would you do with yours? Interesting thoughts, huh? It's kind of interesting to think that you have so many different kinds of music at your disposal as a composer, and you can take them and use them any way you want to make a movie better. This is what makes film composers such an important part to the movie. They can do so many different things to help a movie be better. And when they do it right, you're gonna know that music for years. Well, I'm gonna start over again. We're actually gonna move on to the last slide here. And before we say goodbye for the last time for the year, I just wanted to tell you a couple things. First off, I am super proud of all of you this year. I know this year has been really different. you know, you've had to do things over the computer online for most of the year, and you didn't get back to school until almost the end of the school year, but you all did a really great job, and I am proud of you, especially here in music class. I know normally you guys would be coming to my classroom, we'd be playing our instruments, we'd be singing songs. Sixth graders would be starting to do beginning concert band. We'd start you on concert band instruments if you wanted. And I know this was completely different. We weren't able to go to my music room. We weren't able to do things like that. But we still managed to have music. And I hope that you all learned a lot. I hope you all enjoyed it. And I also hope that as you guys move on, you think a little bit more about the music in your life and how much you've learned in this class and hopefully keep on learning. Well, that's all I have time for. So as I say every time, have a great summer, have a great day, and I'll see you next time. Bye.